Now, when it comes to Sarah Palin, the governor of Alaska, the hits just keep on coming. Some of the latest revelations surrounding John McCain's surprise choice of a running mate. The Associated Press reporting a private lawyer has been authorized to spend $95,000 of state money to defend Palin in the trooper ethics probe. Contrary to her message of reform, Palin worked hard to get pork barrel money for her city and her state. And also, according to the AP, her husband was once a member of the Alaska Independence Party. Some members of that group advocate that Alaska secede from the Union. That would not be country first. Also, the boyfriend of Palin's 17-year-old unmarried pregnant daughter expected to join the family at the Republican convention. The McCain camp is pushing back hard on all this. It's calling questions about Palin's background a faux media scandal designed to destroy the first female Republican nominee for vice president and suggesting that Palin is a victim of gender bias in the media. Where have we heard that before? They insist Palin was subject to a long and thorough vetting process. Really? The Washington Post reported this morning the head of McCain's vetting team didn't do an in-depth interview with Governor Palin until the day before she was offered the number two slot on the ticket. Some are wondering if Sarah Palin could turn out to be another Harriet Myers, a vastly underqualified woman who was nominated by President Bush to become a Supreme Court justice. Myers later had to withdraw her name from consideration. Gee, there's that parallel again. No presidential candidate has withdrawn his VP choice since Democrat George McGovern in 1972. McGovern dropped Tom Eagledon after 18 days when revelations surfaced about Eagledon's mental health. Eagledon, too, had been a last-minute selection. So here's the question. Should John McCain consider replacing Sarah Palin on the GOP ticket? Go to CNN.com/CaffertyFile and post a comment on my blog. Not since Katrina have we seen the volume of email on a story that we've seen on this one since last Friday when Palin was announced. We've gotten over 30,000 emails in the 2 days, Friday and yesterday, just on this story alone. I mean, it's just unprecedented.
And would you say most are going one way or the other? Are they sort of both these emails split down the middle? I know you haven't done a scientific survey, Jeff.
I haven't even read them.
You read a lot of them.
30,000 emails would take me till next Christmas. It's just an interesting water cooler type subject of discussion. The Democrats are kind of divided over whether he ought to replace her because some of them think her being on the ticket will help Obama's chances. And some of the Republicans are the same way. Women are kind of divided. It's an interesting mix of opinions, but she certainly has captured the attention of all of us in a way that none of these politicians has managed to do in a good long while. So for however long this lasts, it makes the campaign a lot more interesting than it was before she jumped into the mix.
Jack for the Cafferty File. Jack.
Does the rest of the world do elections like we do here in the colonies?
No, I think
they don't.
This is a unique experience.
This is the comedy relief for the entire planet for this year.
Question this hour: should John McCain consider replacing Sarah Palin on the Republican ticket? Tony writes in Connecticut: no do-overs. If McCain took advice from those bumbling fools who found her, he has to live with losing the election. He would have lost anyway, but he's going to go down hard now. Berta writes, quite a conundrum, Ajax. A, he replaces her, looks like the foolish, impulsive, misogynistic goofball that he is. B, he keeps her and looks like the foolish, impulsive, misogynistic goofball that he is. I vote for all of the above, but then I'm voting for Obama. Daryl writes, ha, wouldn't you love that? Not a chance. She's going to put him over the top. Just wait till the polls come out next week. Michael writes, it seems to me the Republicans are the ones exploiting the pregnant daughter of Sarah Palin. They are marching her around the convention like she's some kind of a trophy. These people are just way too hypocritical for me, and within the next 10 days, I believe Sarah Palin will step down due to family considerations. Jason in Illinois, this pick has one major benefit for Republicans in that she energizes the right-wing base. The problem is the base isn't enough to win anymore. Dumping her would say that this was a cynical political pick to begin with, further damaging McCain's increasingly shaky image as someone who wants to reform Washington. He's made his bed, now he's got to lie in it. Keith writes, he should, but I hope he doesn't. Yet, I hate the fact that I can't turn away from a train wreck. Paul writes, not at all. It's just what the liberals want. She's more qualified than Barack Obama to be the president. And Annan in New York writes, no, this plays out better than Desperate Housewives or any of the soap operas. If you didn't see your email here, you can go to my blog at cnn.com/CaffertyFile. Look for yours there among hundreds of others. I'm older than you are, and I can't remember any vice presidential candidate kicking up this much dust.
Thomas Eagleton back in 1972 when he was dumped by George McGovern. What do you think about that?
Well, yeah, but that was a little different. It was, they found out he had some electric shock treatments and been treated for some mental illness, and they jettisoned him about 18 days after he was nominated. But he did, as I recall, and I was working in Kansas City at the time, he didn't come to the party with all of the attendant accoutrement as Governor Palin has. It was a kind of a cut and dry deal. He was there for a couple of weeks. They said, oh, we found some medical records. He's out of here. Kind of a surgical deal by comparison.
All right. Okay, Jack, stand by.